Let's get debate number one started. And on debate number one tonight, is it saving democracy or saving the Gandhis? Chandan Mitra of the BJP, we have R. Rajagopalan, senior journalist, leans towards the BJP on this. The hashtag tonight is Augusta Impact. Alok Mehta, chief editor, Outlook Hindi. Suman C. Raman, political commentator, I'm told he's critical of the BJP on this. Danish Ali, national general secretary of the JDS. Ajay Alok of the JDU and the empty chair. Now, I was told some Congress leaders were very upset at the fact that we put a glass of water next to the empty chair and said it's available. So, I'll take away the glass of water, but the empty chair still remains. I just put the glass of water there as a consideration in case they want to sit on the empty chair and want to have a glass of water with it. But today I take the glass of water away, but the empty chair is available to any of those who may want to consider it. Now, viewers, let's start the debate. My question is, Alok Mehta, let's start with you. Let's start with Mr. Rajagopalan. I'm curious to know how Robert Wadra, with his illustrious background, which we don't have to go into details about, the things he has done, the things he thankfully did not do, the things he probably almost did, right? And the things he's threatening to do, because I feel threatened that now he's offered to serve the country by entering politics. I just want to know, how is Robert Wadra going to save democracy? Alok Mehta and Mr. Rajagopalan, that debate is to you, please. Yeah. Uh-huh. Alok Mehta. How will Robert Wadra save our democracy? Alok Mehta, you want to take that?
Robert Wadra will save our democracy by looting the country. He will loot the country, thereby he will save democracy. It is a palace secret which Sonia Gandhi, Rahul Gandhi, Priyanka Gandhi and Robert Wadra has hatched a conspiracy to save democracy.
Also on the debate tonight, KTS Tulsi. I can also see. I want to formally introduce KTS Tulsi, member of the Rajya Sabha, senior advocate, Supreme Court. Sorry, sir, for missing you out in the initial introduction. Welcome to the debate. Okay, Mr. Alok Mehta, the most embarrassing moment of the day today when you put Robert Wadra right there in the middle as the mascot to save Indian democracy. Yeah. Why did they do that? Yeah, why do you think they did that?
I agree with you, but maybe people supporting Robert Wadra and even the Congress people don't want. But you can't stop in such democracy. Number of people come. And if you remember, Arnab, once upon a time, the BJP people and Janata Party used to hate Menaka Gandhi and at that time, the Sanjay Gandhi time. So they used to say Gandhi is coming.
No, I don't think this can be a mistake, because sir, the fact is there was not one poster. There were like tens and dozens of posters with Robert Wadra in the middle.
It's a calculated one.
Point number two. We've been asking
this. What Alok Mehta says is wrong.
No, one second. Mr. Rajagopalan, please, Mr. Rajagopalan, play down your strong feelings.
Menaka Gandhi was at the time in Sanjay Gandhi time. Remember those days?
How is Robert Wadra going to save our democracy? Question I take forward. Let's get Chandan Mitra. Chandan Mitra and Suman C. Raman into the debate, please. Jayanta Ghoshal joins in also. Yes, Jayanta, Suman C. Raman, how is Robert Wadra going to save our democracy?
Robert Wadra. Yeah. On Robert Wadra, I think it's absolutely ridiculous. This must probably, if it has not been done by some local worker in his enthusiasm.
No, it can't be. It's an official post. Hundreds of posters of Robert Wadra emblazoning the same democracy march.
It would be wise on the part of the Congress party to issue a clarification whether this was authorized by the party high command.
Now they can't do anything about it. The fact of the matter is, he was there, people saw it, and the fact is everyone's saying tonight across the country that this is not about saving democracy. This is about saving the family.
All I'm saying is,
this is about saving the family.
See that.
Sumant, listen, let's be realistic about it.
No,
maximum
we know the answer.
Maximum number of people are talking about the fact that the Congress party future leadership will include Robert Wadra.
The Congress party tomorrow, you know that it's not something that they have objected to. It's very simple. If they don't clarify about these posters, then you know very clearly it's something that they have sort of actively supported.
Clarify, people would want an apology for it. What clarification? You put up Robert Wadra.
Clarification first.
Is it a joke? given his track record.
Now
come on, Chandan Mitra. Chandan Mitra, please. Chandan Mitra into the debate. No, we can't wish it aside. We cannot wish it aside.
Congress party must clarify as to whether Mr. Robert Vadra holds a position in the Congress party. Is he leading this march in his private capacity along with Mrs. Sonia Gandhi, who is the president of the party, and Mr. Rahul Gandhi, who is the vice president of the party? So what is Mr. Robert Vadra?
No, the poster says Loktantra Bachao. The poster says KTS Tulsi, Ajay Alok and others. The poster says Loktantra Bachao. Let's put pictures up there, please, viewers. By the way, we are not making this up. Many people are asking us if these are real posters. Viewers, these are real posters. This was the face of the Congress party Loktantra Bachao rally today. Robert Vadra right there in the middle, flanked to his right by Sonia Gandhi, to his left by Rahul Gandhi. This is the new face of the Congress party Save Democracy campaign. Now, we can't wish it aside, can we?
Yes.
Can we, KTS Tulsi, if Robert Vadra is going to be the face of the Save Democracy campaign, then obviously we are going to be concerned about it. Why do you think this happened? Is it essentially about protecting the Gandhis? Yes.
I haven't seen these posters.
Sir, they are all over.
No, very well, they may be all over. I don't go all over. I haven't seen it. But the question really will be, who has got them printed and published? And who's put them up? I don't know.
Congress workers.
I know nothing.
In a Congress rally.
I don't know. No, you are presuming. You may have basis for presuming, but I don't.
Mr. Tulsi, you are
I can't comment
Mr. Tulsi,
on that.
Chandan Mitra responding to Chandan Mitra. Yeah.
Can you deny?
No.
Mr. Tulsi, you are a very respected lawyer. Can you deny the fact that these posters are there? You've seen pictures of that.
I'm not denying.
Who is he? Why
I can't even
there?
See because
as
I don't have
Congress,
the television
Congress
screen
party
in front
person,
of me.
You.
No, and all of this is happening.
No, you have to answer this.
No, all of this, I mean, Mr. Tulsi, is happening at a time when he has issued.
How can this man, who is basically a land grabber, he is there right in the middle of the Congress poster.
I mean, it's embarrassing.
So you have to tell us, who is he?
Anyway, I don't want to waste too much time on Robert Vadra.
A lot of time,
yeah.
Mischief is created by other parties.
Oh, so you're saying BJP planted the posters. Danish Ali. This is the new angle now. You're saying BJP planted Robert Vadra's posters. Danish Ali, please. So many reactions on this. Danish Ali.
Are you serious? Are you serious?
I think what Mr.
I'm not
KTS
serious.
Is saying,
are you serious?
It's not fair that
I'm serious about.
No, I'm only.
But this is a brazen attempt by the so-called sycophants within the Congress party.
Yes.
Who want something in the Congress party by appeasing Mr. Robert Vadra. And this politics of son-in-laws of the powerful families, I do remember. No action has been taken till now by the NDA government? Or why till 10 years UPA ruled, why not a single action was taken against the NDA son-in-law? During opposition, I do remember the Congress party used to say that the foster son of then Prime Minister was involved in the dealings of the hotels which were sold out on a penny, very few underpriced by the
IBC. Anyway.
You all remember, we all remember. But nothing has happened.
But Danish Ali,
nothing is going to happen here also, Mr. Arnab Goswami. This politics of son-in-law, only they want to target each other.
Anyway, I only presented this before our viewers. Danish, listen. I'll get a word from Ajay Alok. Let me clarify. I don't think this man, what's his name? Robert Vadra, is that terribly important that we should spend more than 10 minutes discussing him. But I am concerned today because a lot of people, Ajay Alok, wrote to us saying, did you notice that Mr. Are You Serious was the center of the Save Loktantra campaign, and that instead of removing his posters, the Congress party allowed his posters to be the centerpiece of the Save Democracy campaign. Was this not brazen, Ajay Alok? Even though you are an ally of the Congress party, does this not upset you? Worry you in some way? Ajay Alok, that this has become so brazen now? Or are you also going to fall in line with it? Don't forget, you once called the Congress the mother of corruption. Well, yes, please. Ajay Alok?
Well, Mr. Goswami, I'm not a spokesperson for the Congress that I'll speak on their behalf.
No, but you're an ally of the Congress.
Well, as a neutral person, I'll just say ally, we are ally.
Sir, are you distancing yourself from the Congress after Agastya?
But I'm not at all. Not at all. Let me tell you right from the beginning, I'm coming on your program for Agastya. My stand is very clear and I still maintain that stand. But as far as Mr. Robert Wadra posters flying out and you're making an issue out of it, let me ask you one question. Is Mr. Robert Wadra a criminal? Is Mr. Robert Wadra a fugitive? Is Mr. Robert Wadra a person non grata? Who are we to raise this question? This is the question for the Congress party.
Yeah.
Who are we to introspect within the Congress party?
No.
For something to Congress to introspect.
No, it's not. No, but
why Mr. Arnab Goswami is raising questions?
No, but one second. Are you snatching away from me my right to ask questions? Are you snatching away from me my right to ask questions? I am asking a question and viewers. No, 1 second, Ajay, listen. You're a reasonable man on most occasions.
This is something within the Congress party.
No, 1 second.
Ajay Alok, listen.
I myself said that it's not worth spending more than 10 minutes on Robert Wadra, which should give you an indication of what I stand. I don't think
so
that he's
on,
no, let, but I've raised the point, but at the same time,
let's
at the same time,
topic,
at the same time, are Ajay, meri baat sun lijiye, fir aap vartalap kijiye sabke beech mein. But my point is, and I'll move on from Robert Wadra after this, but my point is, are you telling me today that as an independent journalist in this country, right, who disregards the empty chair and does his job, that I will not be allowed to ask a question to the people of this country which will be in the minds of everyone today, kai bhai aur koi nahi mila, that Robert Wadra has to be allowed on posters to save our democracy? I'm not saying he's good, bad, convict, fugitive, anything. These are words that you use. I'm simply saying, is he qualified by anyone to put him up there? Because you're having a whole save democracy campaign.
In
it's an observation
politics,
of mine. Anyway, I move
politics,
on now.
There is no qualification.
Since you're getting upset with my discussing Robert Wadra, I'm going to move on.
In Indian politics, there is no qualification required to hold any chair or any position.
Oh, tell
in
me,
Indian
I know
politics,
that.
This is
Trust me, I know that. Trust
politics.
Me, we all know that.
There is no education qualification. There is no.
Trust me, I know that. Should we move on? Should
anyone
we move on? Okay, here's
the
so question.
If Congress party decides him to make him the leader.
Let's move on. Join the Ghoshal is smiling tonight.
Arnab, don't you feel embarrassing when the Sakshi Maharaj, what he was doing?
Oh, Arnab, utterly embarrassed.
Why?
Yogi Adityanath, Sakshi Maharaj and all these
Yogi
people.
Adhita, what they are doing?
It's absolutely embarrassing.
Robert Wadra, more shameful about the Sakshi Maharaj.
Yes, so
you
if
should
someone
also
puts,
discuss the Sakshi Maharaj,
so if,
what he was doing with the girls.
So listen, so if Sakshi
what
Maharaj...
What he was doing on the camera.
Listen, if someone
you
puts up
also
a...
You discuss that also.
No, 1 second. Alok Mehta, good point. I'll tell you. If someone puts up a poster with Sakshi Maharaj's picture or Yogi Adityanath's picture and says Loktantra Bachao, I will be equally upset about it.
They talk the UP. They say UP Bachao. They are the face of the BJP.
Okay, let's go into substantive issues.
Prime Minister, they want the Prime Minister election.
Yeah.
How you come here? They are the symbol of the democracy. They are the member of parliament of the BJP. What they are doing in the camera?
Yeah.
And even then,
you
don't finish and talk about them.
Hopefully, and that will put this matter to rest.
Okay, can we move on, Sumant, from this issue? My question. Now I go into the issue.
Yes.
Before they walked out of parliament, the Congress was up on its feet today and Mallikarjun Kharge said, and I want to put this question to Jayanta Ghoshal, we take the debate forward. They said, Supreme Court, we want a Supreme Court monitored investigation into Agastya Westland. I say that that's a damn good idea.
It's imperative now.
No. I say that's a damn good idea.
It's imperative now.
It's imperative now, says Ajay Alok. Then my question is this, that it was the UPA that instead said there was no wrongdoing and zero loss in the 2G case. Till the Supreme Court.
Why did they not do it?
No. 1 second. Why should we not have a Supreme Court monitor investigation? I don't have a problem with it. But the point is, did the Congress party ask for a Supreme Court monitor investigation into the 2G case? Ajay Alok, no. Did they? Jayanta Ghoshal, no.
No.
No, they didn't. The Supreme Court intervened on the basis of a public interest litigation and struck down the 122 licenses that were allotted.
Because
it was a result of a PIL.
They did go for a joint parliamentary. They did go for a JPC. They did go for a JPC.
Sir, there was
but
a PIL.
Why is imperative? That is most important. Because
sorry, Ajay Alok. Okay,
what's heard
it?
From the Prime Minister today?
No, but I think there's nothing wrong with
the
Supreme Court monitored investigation. I, in fact, support it.
Let me tell you. I was agreeing till the point in the daytime when I was hearing the Lok Sabha debate. I also agreed, okay, fine. Let the CBI investigate. But why Supreme Court becomes imperative after hearing the Prime Minister's speech? the way he spoke at the rally, that sometimes instills some kind of a fear factor among the officials who will be investigating the case. Because look how this Prime Minister is speaking.
What did he say?
Imperative after his speech that this.
No, what did he say?
What he didn't say.
Okay, Chandan Mitra is responding. Chandan Mitra.
No, I want to ask him, what was wrong?
Sometimes he really forgets that he has become the Prime Minister of this country. Sometimes the Prime Minister forgets that he has
what
become
was
the
wrong?
Prime Minister of this country.
It is up to him how he wants to speak at a public rally.
It is
up to him. And what? So what? Who are you? Who are you? Who are you to dictate his style of speaking? Who is he?
आपको कौन मना कर रहा है? कीजिए ना. हम तो यही कह रहे हैं कि आप इन्वेस्टिगेशन करो. 2013 onward CBI filed the case. UPI delayed it. Fine, agreed to you.
Okay, Chandan Mitra, let him complete his point, then you respond. Chandan, respond after he completes his point. Ajay Alok, what's your basic point? Make your point so that Chandan Mitra can respond after that. What's your basic point?
My basic point is.
No, no, one sec. Chandan Mitra, just wait a while. Wait a while. Chandan Mitra, Dr. Chandan Mitra, wait a while. Let him complete his point. Yeah, complete your point.
Prime Minister is no more an activist. He has become the Prime Minister now for the last 2 years. He should act. If the UPA delayed the investigation from 2013 to 2014, what they were doing from 2014 to 2016? They were sitting ducks? Why they are not taking action? Investigate and get the action. And like what in the previous debate somebody said, I was listening to that. Let this Augusta be finished by August. What's the harm? Say it on the channel that we will do it and we'll find the culprits and we'll nab them. Instead of making rhetoric and instead of going on giving lectures. We have heard enough of it. We don't want another force to come down.
Okay, Chandan Mitra will respond. Chandan Mitra, you were the ones calling for a Supreme Court monitored investigation in all the other cases. When the Congress party was in power, there is a point to be made here. You can't back off from that now. Please respond directly to that charge. Also, I think I second the charge. Let there be a time-bound inquiry into this matter. Let it not drag till 2019. If there are politicians involved, Chandan Mitra, let us not live by innuendo and die by innuendo. Let us make the position very clear. If there is an investigation, please don't tell me that you'll have to drag your feet for the next 3 years. Why can't you do it in 3 months? As they say in Hindi, dood ka dood aur pani ka pani ho jayega in this case. Go ahead, Chandan Mitra. And Danish Ali will respond. Arnab, yeah, go on.
Arnab, you must understand that time-bound thing is up to the investigative agencies. We can't tell them that yes, you can complete investigation in the 7 days.
Yeah.
And in any case, Sumantra, any problem, let there be a Supreme Court monitored investigation.
No, Dani.
But you can't throw.
What Danish is responsible. Danish.
To have a time-bound
but
inquiry.
But more importantly, I think Mr. Ajay Alok.
That is why Ajay the Supreme Alok Court monitored inquiry is
needed. Prime Minister
so that it can direct the agencies, investigative agencies, to complete
really
the process,
that he
complete the investigation in time.
The Prime
and you know why today the government is afraid of having
why is
a Supreme
why is he
Court
talking,
monitored inquiry.
Who
because
is he?
Today, in the Uttarakhand president's rule case, they have got their reply from the Supreme Court that you can't demolish the democracy,
you can't demolish
the elected government.
Listen, whoever you are.
Danish Ali, that's Danish Ali of the JDS. Please address him directly, Chandan Mitra.
Danish Ali, do you want a Supreme Court monitor inquiry or not? You forget everything else. Do you want it or do you not want it?
There should be a Supreme Court monitored inquiry. What's wrong in that?
Why aren't you allowing it, Chandan Mitra? Why aren't you allowing it? You should be also pushing for it. What's wrong with it?
Because you just want to make an issue of it. You don't want to take action against the culprit who has taken the bribe.
CBI and by the ED. And this was done only by the NDA government when it came to power. We exposed the Congress which was trying to cover it up. And now the whole thing is open and you wait as Mr. Parikar.
Okay, Chandan Mitra.
This won't be
both. Chandan Mitra. Chandan Mitra. Chandan Mitra. Chandan Mitra. 1 minute. 1 minute. Danish Ali, please wait. Danish Ali, please wait. Danish Ali, please wait. Danish Ali, please wait. Let me make my position clear on this matter. Crystal clear, Chandan Mitra and Danish Ali. I believe and I also believe KTS Tulsi will agree with me. I believe Alok Mehta will agree with me, and I hope Chandan Mitra and Rajagopalan agree with me. I, like all Indians, want to see a Supreme Court monitored investigation, because whether you like it or not, don't shake your head, Rajagopalan.
It cannot be.
Rajagopalan, don't shake your head.
CBI.
3 months, 6 months.
That is undermining
year.
CBI.
No, no, what's the problem?
It is undermining CBI.
How is it undermining CBI?
CBI.
I'm sorry.
No problem.
Don't give me this argument.
Let the CBI be over.
Sorry, Rajagopalan. Sorry, Mr. Rajagopalan.
It's been handled in the CBI court. Everybody knows
you cannot bring Supreme Court all of a sudden. Supreme Court was to be brought in. Why Congress did not go for Supreme Court? Why Congress wasted 1 year? Why Congress wasted 1 full year? Danish Ali should answer. Ajay Alok should answer to this.
Ajay Alok.
Why Congress did not...
Ajay Alok and Jayanta Goswal hasn't come in yet. Ajay Alok.
You have a license to waste 5 years.
Okay, Mr. Rajagopalan, Ajay Alok is responding, please.
Congress has wasted 1 year, you get a license to waste 5 years. Your defense minister today agreed that in 2003 in the Lok Sabha, your defense minister said
in 2 years
the change by the Indian government. You didn't have any answer to that.
It is because of Italy court it was delayed.
Brajesh Mishra was
you must understand that there is no delay from
you didn't have any answer for that.
Indian courts.
What are you talking about?
The judgment
I am on the issue.
Brajesh Mishra is a Congress agent.
It's a right question. No need of Supreme Court.
Why we should trust you?
It is a political question.
You once you cover your time,
CBI, if you leave CBI in 6 months,
I put this question to you as one of my news hour questions this evening using the hashtag Augusta Impact. My question to you is, which I simultaneously will put now to a gentleman called KTS Tulsi, who's been listening very patiently, and another gentleman called Jayanta Goswal and Alok Mehta, who've been staying quiet in the debate. Welcome into the debate, RSN Singh. My point is, listen, Mr. Tulsi, I believe that Supreme Court monitored investigation is the need of the day. But please, Mr. KTS Tulsi and Jayanta Goswal, feel free to come in. Please accept today the Congress party talking about a Supreme Court or monitored investigation is supremely and horrifically ironic. Because in September 2011, the UPA opposed the monitoring of the investigation into the 2G spectrum case by the Supreme Court. In September 2013, Jayanta Goswal, the Congress government opposed the Supreme Court's view that in court-monitored probes like Colgate, the CBI does not need the center's approval to examine officers. This is the track record of the Congress party. I'm not saying what they are saying now is wrong, but what I'm saying is they may not have the moral authority to be saying it. Jayanta Goswal, can we please seal this issue about a Supreme Court-monitored investigation once and for all? Will the Modi government agree to it in your view? Yes, please. Mr. Goswal. I think I lost Jayanta Goswal there. I think I lost the audio with KTS Tulsi as well. Yes, Danish Ali.
Only in the Supreme Court monitored inquiry, the CBI and the agencies plays an impartial role. That has been established. Otherwise, the example I am giving you in Shri Yedurappa's case, how CBI has behaved in Yedurappa's case. That is why we
Alok Mehta. Alok Mehta.
Congress, I'm not
Alok Mehta.
But
Arnab, you are right country, when you say Alok 2011
Mehta. Important case
in
like
2011
deal,
Arnab, 2011 Dr. Manmohan Singh was the Prime Minister, CBI was reporting to him, and that's why they were not accepting the Supreme Court. So you are very right, and that's why now the Prime Minister, he's a different Prime Minister, Narendra Modi. Why he can't stop? Because I can understand the Manmohan Singh was not ready because he was aware that Supreme Court will attack on him also. That's why I'm thinking.
No, that is not
because
the
CBI, because certainly you are not taking name of the Manmohan Singh. He was the Prime Minister. He was signing in the coal affair. He was signing for the other deals.
So what?
He could the Prime Minister. He was also responsible.
Some other minister. That's not a problem. They wanted to hide.
Now the Prime Minister Narendra Modi, why he is not accepting the Supreme Court supervision? Because CBI report direct to the Prime Minister.
The inquiry
don't
is
report
on.
To everybody.
CBI
also leak your
CBI
friends.
CBI and ED are both
number of people and they leak the media everywhere.
Okay, one second.
And no you need
something
you can't
that.
Dictate, you
at
can't
the fact that they want to drag the case.
CBI can dictate.
Well, I go to
Congress is wanting to drag
okay,
the
gentlemen,
case.
Gentlemen, one second. I need to move on to the next point. But I've got the line with Jayanta Ghoshal and KTS Tulsi back, and I'm asking Jayanta Ghoshal and KTS Tulsi one after the other. How long will we keep debating whether there has to be a Supreme Court monitored investigation? Have it out. Let there be one, Jayanta Ghoshal. What's the problem? What really is the problem?
I don't mind with the Supreme Court investigation, but Arnav, it is ridiculous when Congress demands it. Because when Congress was in power, they didn't blacklist the company.
Yeah.
Although Ghulam Nabi Azad in Rajya Sabha said that it was blacklisted, and after that privilege motion was moved. And so when Congress can lie in parliament on this issue, and now that Congress is demanding Supreme Court monitoring on this issue. And Manmohan Singh CBI, that was good. And Narendra Modi CBI, that is bad. This is a very insult to our Indian bureaucracy also.
KTS Tulsi, do respond please. Do
so
respond.
You cannot make a judgment.
Yeah.
Case to case, issue
Arnav.
To issue.
Yeah.
Arnav.
So
yeah.
I think I am telling you, Arnav, that you cannot 2 years, what BJP has done, BJP government has done to CBI. After Italian court judgment, now we are asking, but that doesn't mean that CBI didn't do anything for the last 2 years. They may not have any press
Chandan
conference.
Mitra, Chandan Mitra,
released anything.
Chandan Mitra, Chandan Mitra, countering Jayanta Ghoshal, Chandan Mitra, please, Chandan Mitra.
Now we are asking.
Chandan Mitra,
so
please.
Now CBI, I think CBI will
Chandan Mitra,
come on. A lot of things.
You know,
we should wait now. And you cannot jump to the decision of the Supreme Court immediately.
Since July, CBI and ED have been successfully, they've investigated 100 people. Questioning has happened, 100 persons have been interrogated. And what do you mean the CBI ED is not going about their job? Now you wanted somebody supervise the matter? I don't think there's a problem of principle, but you cannot accuse the CBI and ED of having gone slow.
He's not accusing the CBI and the ED. He's accusing.
Very systematic.
No. He's saying you've done a go slow on it. KTS Tulsi, can we move on to the next point? I just want a word from KTS Tulsi to the response on the issue about a CBI monitored inquiry and whether the Congress Party is being slightly more than hypocritical about it. Yes, please.
I entirely agree with you that there should be a Supreme Court monitored investigation. And it doesn't mean if the Supreme Court monitored investigation that the investigation will not be by the CBI or by the ED. They will still be investigating, but only under the supervision of the Supreme Court. And when the investigation is under the monitored by the Supreme Court, it acquires credibility. It ensures that there is no witch hunting.
Sir, this question of a witch hunt. No, I want to settle this issue of a witch hunt. I want to settle this issue of a witch hunt. Now we are on the issue of a witch hunt. One minute.
Credibility, you have found it now.
No, what is the witch hunt?
Why you did not find it when
Manmohan
Singh was Prime Minister?
No, Mr. Rajagopal.
The credibility, you found it now, Tulsi?
No, point is tonight, witch hunt is a very
interesting word. Credibility of CBI.
Credibility
of Supreme Court, you found it just now.
No credibility.
Why Congress did not do that action?
Yes. Congress also did it.
Government never had a
just one second.
There was no corruption charge against
just one second,
Arnav. Or Narendra Modi.
No, gentlemen, can I move to the
no
issue of which
charge
no, one question, please.
Where
yes, Suman Sri Raman is taking on Rajagopal. Yes, Suman Sri Raman. Suman Sri Raman, please.
Look. Mr. Mitra said that over the last 2 years, the CBI has done a fantastic job on this case. Look, the cabin height was changed by quote unquote the UPA government. So obviously it was a technical decision. Somebody in the Air Force took that decision.
Don't
that
pass it only to somebody in the Air Force.
You couldn't get Hashka. No, it is not a political decision to change. Somebody has to have a file. On that file you've got to give a reasoning for that. So who are those people who gave that?
Okay, Suman, listen. I raise a question.
Look, I raise a question here.
One second. Suman.
You couldn't get Christian Michel.
Suman. Okay. Now let me draw this debate back. Now there is one question I ask. There is one question that I ask. Over the last few days, viewers, you have seen this fellow. Most unfortunately, if he has done what he has done, he has disgraced the uniform and he'll never be able to rub the stain of that. And that person is Tyagi. Now, you've seen pictures of Tyagi going up and down. Now we see his brother, this Tyagi brothers, their misdeeds, the rot in the system, the stench of their corruption, their greed, their activities, their murky details, the way they sold out the country. I mean, it appears to me tonight that you want to sit on the job of Air Force Chief only to sell out your own country. So there is anger at the country, in the across the country, over the Tyagis. My question is this. Why is the Congress party providing covering fire to the Tyagis? Anyone who calls what is happening today a witch hunt is providing covering fire to the Tyagis. Because are you trying to provide covering fire to the Tyagis in this case, afraid that they might spill the beans during their interrogation with the Central Bureau of Investigation and the Enforcement Directorate? Yes, please, RSN Singh on the debate. It appears to me, RSN Singh. RSN Singh, please. RSN. RSN Singh, intelligence expert. Yes, please, RSN. RSN, I'll come to you. Okay, RSN Singh and Mr. Tulsi, please. RSN.
Sir, I am only interested in fast tracking this whole case. Because, you know, acquisition process of critical items for the security of this nation should not be slowed down. I am only, whether it is monitored by Supreme Court or by the CBI, as far as I am concerned, it is an open and shut case, let me tell you. And Mr. Tulsi, let me tell you, you know, I made a statement that day which, you know, in the din of debate, it could not be heard. 90, you know, Palki Wala had said that 90% of cases they lose and win by themselves. 7% cases are lost because of bad advocacy, and only 3% cases are won because of good advocacy. So, Mr. Tulsi, this falls into that 90% category. The principal accused are identified. Give me 15 minutes with each one of these, whatever their initials may be. I don't know. I don't want to get into that. Within 15 minutes, five of them or six of them, and by tomorrow morning, I can bust the whole case. And as far as my information, the investigations have moved at a very fast pace. They have traveled a long distance as far as the money trail is concerned. This is my information. So let's wait and see. And about caged parrot, let me tell you, you know, the Supreme Court may have said caged parrot, but there have been occasions, many occasions, depending who was at the helm, the caged parrot has been allowed to fly in freedom for some time, unless some, you know, man with criminal mind put it back in the cage. So therefore, let's not, you know, keep repeating verbatim what the Supreme Court said. After all, these institutions will be there.
No, let's go back to the subject. I go back to the subject of a witch hunt. I am interested in settling this issue about a witch hunt. My question is, and please tell me, Ajay Alok and Danish Ali come back to the debate. My point is, why would you call it a witch hunt? Why would you try to exonerate Christian Michael or Michelle or whatever his godforsaken name is?
Yes.
Right now, this fellow, Christian Michelle, why would you quote him and quote his interview with a newspaper where he absolves the Gandhis of any involvement? I mean, it's like saying ki Otavio Quattaro ki ne bol diya ki koi ghus nahi diya gaya Bofors mein. It's exactly like that. Why would you quote Christian Michelle? Come on, Ajay Alok, you're a Congress ally, but you're going to have to answer this question.
Sir, do you
why would you do
Kargil?
That? No, why would you do that? Ajay Alok,
you remember Kargil and the Ajay Alok, controversy?
Ajay Alok.
You played
Ajay Alok.
Nitish India quoted Michelle. He took this reference very clearly. That Michelle name was used, that he had wrote a letter saying that Mrs. Sonia Gandhi and other in the Gandhi family are the driving force that must be taken care of.
Why would you quote Christian Michelle?
If you take that, then why we
Why would you
this?
Quote Christian so Michelle?
This was in a reference. But let me...
No,
let
no,
me
why would out, you quote him?
Let me come again. I don't...
Ajay
I don't
Alok, why would you quote him? You
I'm
tell me.
I'm not at all concerned about Christian Michelle or anyone.
No, but why would you quote Christian Michelle saying Gandhis are not involved?
According to your defense minister. Mr. Goswami.
Why would you quote Christian Michel saying Gandhis are not involved? Please answer me, Ajay.
I'm not quoting.
Not Mr. you, Mr. but they the Congress has.
Forget it. I just have 3 points to make. What Defence Minister quoted today in Lok Sabha, why don't you listen to that? I'm just asking what Defence Minister has said today. Defence Minister very clearly said that in October 2014, we named this company, what you call Augusta Westland and their associate partners, that they can bid in the FIPs. Why? When it was already blacklisted in July, why you invited to be them a part of FIP? Number one. Number two question is, Chandan Mitra, you're getting a counter from Chandan Mitra. When they are blacklisted, when you know they have paid bribes, when you know the CEO has been arrested of these companies, why are you with them? Why are you calling for Make in India? Why are you advising him to go and join the FIP for Indian defense deals? Why are you promoting it?
No, but why would you quote Christian Michel?
No, one second.
Tell me one thing. Do you think people across India have not watched this? Do you think people across India have not noticed this? Ajay Alok, you think people across India have not seen that there is a political party that is trying to detract? That 1 minute, let me complete my argument, please. You are jumping into the argument and not letting me complete a sentence, please. I lose the flow of thought, Ajay. Come on. You've come with your sleeves rolled up into the debate, which I appreciate tonight, but I would appreciate 30 seconds of patience, please. Now, my point tonight is, anyone today who's defending the Congress party, explain this to me. Let Alok Mehta explain it to me. He's a very, very senior journalist. Alok Mehta was an editor when we entered the profession. Now, let me ask Alok Mehta. And on both sides tonight, we have two people who've been in journalism. The question tonight, Alok Mehta, you tell me, why would a political party try to detract from an element of political involvement knowing that the mention of their leaders' names in the notes related to this scam may come back to haunt them? Why would you quote Christian Michel? Why did the Congress party quote Christian Michel? Why did they? Alok Mehta.
I don't know. If they can quote Headley for some purpose, then why can't they talk about Michel? When I'm not supporting.
RSN is getting countered.
I am sorry to say this is a very poor argument when you have spent, lakhs of dollars to send a team to interrogate Headley. It was only to find a lead. Nobody has been punished just on basis of Headley's revelations. Remember this. These are just interrogations. So don't compare
that's
this.
Right.
And I'm sorry to say that you are an editor of a...
When you are talking, why you are quoting, that's what I'm telling you. But otherwise, I always feel that the Supreme Court...
Okay, Chandan Mitra.
Our investigative agency should report to Supreme Court.
Chandan Mitra.
I'm just supporting what RSN Singh said. How can you compare Headley with this Christian Michel? And unless there is something that the Congress party has which they have to hide, why would they quote Christian Michel?
Now the question, the relevance and is no the comparison has also been drawn to Beaufort. One sec, Ajay Alok.
Established bribes have been paid.
Why can't Congress find out who are the people
okay.
who got the bribes and expose them?
Okay. Now can I make a small point?
What you were doing for last 2 years?
Now Ajay Alok, listen. Comparison has been drawn to Beaufort. Tonight, you would see.
You are trying to hush it up.
Okay, Danish Ali.
Protection.
Danish Ali.
This government came to power. Hand it over to CBI,
CBI, 100 people have been interrogated for the last two and a half years. Now they want action.
Okay,
you set fire to where the files were kept.
Okay, one second.
Parikar today clarified that only 3 files could be saved.
Okay, Jayanta Ghoshal, if he's
the
on the debate.
Files were set on fire.
Jayanta Ghoshal, what did in your view, Sumant, one minute. Now we are going to the most controversial part of the debate. One second, just give me a minute of your patience, please. Now on the issue of the comparison with Beaufort. Now my question to you, Jayanta Ghoshal, is this, and please hear me carefully. Why did Manohar Parikar say that what was not done in Beaufort, we will do in Augusta? What did he mean by that, in your view? What did he mean by that? And Sumant, you can respond after Jayanta Ghoshal completes his point. Yeah, Jayanta Ghoshal, why did he say that?
Yeah.
Very simple. You know, when Beaufort's case was there, there are several instances. I don't want to go to the details because it's time. But actually how the case has been diluted on several points That is now crystal clear for any investigating officials. If you can talk to them, they will explain you. This government now on serious is Agastya. They don't want to dilute any points. The problem is that Congress is defensive now on this issue. And Congress is on this raising the Supreme Court issue. Actually, they want to divert the issue from the CBI to Supreme Court. And the CBI investigation, whether what they have done and what they are doing, that Congress doesn't want to listen. Before that, they want to jump to the conclusion that we need Supreme Court investigation. So now it is very clear that Congress is very much defensive on this issue. And when Bofors took place, Arnab, what you said,
Arnab, that Bofors, Arnab, there is a difference.
Points.
When, Arnab, there no, is no, a difference I, between I, Bofors when, and now.
No, no, 1 minute, 1 minute.
Okay, Sumant first, one, RSN, let Sumant make his minute. Point. Let Sumant make his point. If but Bofors, before you say, Sumant.
If Bofors did not go through to completion, as Mr. Parikar said in Parliament today, he also was referring to the 6 years of Mr. Vajpayee's government in between, where too they had an opportunity, but then nothing much happened, right? So it's not just one party's fault that Bofors wasn't taken through to fruition. Second, in Bofors, you had clear accounts into which specific remittances had been made, and all of that was traced, and despite that, nothing happened. Here, we haven't reached that stage yet.
Okay,
third,
Sumant.
Very, very important point
Sumant.
In terms of... No, one minute.
No, Sumant, you've not understood the basic issue between Bofors and this case. Can I please give you a perspective on this? Can I give you a perspective on this? Can I give you a perspective on this? With your permission. With your permission. And I will let... 1 second. While Rajagopalan, just calm down.
The politics of investigation...
No. 1 second. Just calm down on this. I want to give a perspective as far as Bofors is concerned. If I have 20 seconds... 20 seconds of indulgence from the panelists.
The Babri Boss demolition case also.
No. Jayantoda, I want to give just 20 seconds of perspective. All of you are much more
experienced. And the politics of investigation, there are two different issues.
No, all of you. On this panel, there are at least four senior journalists who are very experienced. But I would request you give me 20 seconds. And if I am wrong, say Arnab, you are completely wrong. I would say this, that Bofors never went to fruition because in the year 1993, a man called Ottavio Quattrocchi fled and was allowed to flee this country. He went to Kuala Lumpur when he got news that there's going to be a CBI arrest warrant against him. I was not in journalism then, but I can tell you that I find shocking parallels, but Chandan Mitra was, and maybe Jayanta Ghoshal was in journalism then, and so was Mr. Rajagopalan. As someone who came into journalism later, I find shocking parallels between the way in which Ottavio Quattrocchi left India in 1993. He was never found till 2013 when he died in a foreign land. So he got away for 20 years. On the other hand, we have a situation, a person called Christian Michel. He fled India one day after the CBI was about to file a preliminary inquiry against him. The same party was in power in 1993 and the same party was in power in 2012. So Bofors never went to fruition because we never locked up Quattrocchi. We didn't lock up Quattrocchi. Now we want Christian Michel locked up. That's the difference. We didn't pursue the case. Am I wrong?
Sir,
am I wrong, Alok Mehta? Am I wrong? We didn't pursue the case.
Sir, what I have been trying to say.
Alok Mehta, you tell me, am I wrong?
Because of two reasons.
No, one at a time. Alok Mehta first. One at a time. Alok Mehta first.
You are right that in 1993, if he flew, it's because of the Congress government. But don't forget, Arun Nehru joined BJP. And Arun Nehru was also behind. I was the only person I interviewed Oro Palme.
No role in this.
Was in India.
Sorry.
That's why I'm telling
you. Arun Nehru had no role
in this. Arun.
Chandan Mitra countering. Chandan Mitra. Chandan Mitra countering Alok Mehta.
When I met Oro Palme, Arun Nehru was sitting there for 2 hours.
Arun Nehru had no role in the Bofors investigation.
I know. Arun Nehru, he used to talk. He used to give the slips. He used to talk about this. I'm Chandan Ji.
I know.
But BJP accepted him. BJP accepted him.
Okay, quick last round.
After VP Singh.
Okay, it's been an interesting debate. We need to close in a minute. We need to close in a minute. No. 1 second.
Who is Arun Nehru?
The difference is that today's generation is not as smitten by the white skin.
Okay, calm down, viewers. My last point tonight. Last point. And my last point tonight, please, Ajay Alok, Danish Ali, accept the fact. Bofors case failed, some people will say, because the middleman was never brought back to India to spill the beans. Christian Michel and Guido Haske must be brought back to India, kicking and screaming if required, to spill the beans.
Who's going to get them back?
Pardon me?
Who's going to get them back?
Well, any government, this government will have to get them back. This government will have to get them back.
Which government?
This government, the Modi government, will have to get them back. Or any government have to get them back.
Minutes of interrogation time with each of these characters.
Pardon me? What's wrong? Is it an impossible task?
Before 2019 or after that, Mr. Goswami, please ask Chandran Mitra to declare it in front of the national television.
What? What? Declare what?
Before 2019 or after 2019, Mr. Michel will be brought back. He's a British citizen. Today, Defence Minister has given a statement in the Parliament.
I think exception.
And what about then Malia? And what about Mr. Modi? All these people need to go and be brought back by this government.
I'm only appealing to you to cooperate with the government, because you know everything. You know.
Okay, viewers. We will cooperate. Viewers, it's been a great debate.
They have stashed it away. You please cooperate.
But you give an assurance that you are going to do it.
You know where the money is.
Well, I want to tell you.
I just wish,
and I put a question to viewers tonight.
Which Congress MP went to Dubai?
Where is the money? Please tell us.
Now, I'm wrapping this up. Okay, gentlemen, calm down. I'm wrapping this up with full frame pictures of the shot of the day, and that is of a person who is ready to enter into public service to save the nation. And viewers, no guesses here. That person is on your screen. He's ready to save the nation. Would you have the nation saved by him? Thank you very much for joining me on debate number one on the News Hour tonight. Thank you.